I just video, I sent it on Google, for the chapter three test. Number one, which term best describes 11 and 13? If I split off these two lines. This is my transversal. 11's here, 13's here. There, low. Interior angles, all on the same side, so they're consecutive interior angles. Number two, find the measured angle two, if G is parallel to H, find if Y is parallel to XC, if the measured angle five is 70. First thing I want to do is write 70 in there. You want to find the measured angle two. So again, I want to split off the lines that I want to see. This is 70, that's angle two, we know that these two lines are parallel. They're alternate interior angles, so they have to be the same. So angle two would have to be 70. Three, they want us to find the value of Y. If I'm looking here, I know I need this line for Y, well, there's one, two, and three. I need that line because that's the end of the unit of Y. I don't want this angle because it's got X, and X and Y, even though they are, they would be alternate exterior angles. That's not gonna help us because you put the same thing in there, so I'm gonna use angle, or line one up here. So line one. Line three. This is our transversal. We know that this is 126, this is 60 plus 6. This is 5y minus 4. These two angles would have that, it would be 180, but one's got a y, one's got a z, so we don't want to set up that equation. This angle and this angle are corresponding angles, so they have to be equal to each other so we can set up the equation. 5y minus 4 has to equal 126. Add 4 on both sides. 5y equals 130. Divide both sides by 5. That's going to give you your answer what y equals. I'll let you figure that out. Number 4, determine the slope of a line perpendicular to line GH. This is line GH. First thing I want to do is find the slope of line GH. Could use the slope formula to find the coordinates of these two points. The easier way probably is just to count. We have your rise, looks like you go up 1, 2, 3. That's your rise. From there, I go over 1 to the right. So that's your run. So that's the slope of line GH. Well, we don't want the slope of line GH, we want the slope of a line perpendicular to that. Well, the slope of a line perpendicular to that is going to have a slope that's the opposite reciprocal, somewhere like this. If lines are perpendicular, then slopes are opposite reciprocal. Take your slope. You want the opposite, it was positive, so it's going to be negative. And you flip it over. Well, it's 3 over 1, so your new slope is going to be 1 over 3. That's your answer. one thing, two or three rows, which lines must be parallel. Angle one is right here. Angle two is right here. Remember, you want just the three lines that help to make up those two angles. One of them is this line. Look at that line right here. The other one is this line. Then our transversal would be, also be there. That's angle one, that's angle two, alternate exterior angles. Well, if you're alternate exterior angles, then these two lines have to be parallel if those angles are congruent. So this is line AB, or it could be line AC, or it could be line BC. This other line is line DB, or line DF, or line BF. Can you name any of those places? So we got your answer, see which one's where. DB, that's this line, that's our transversal, it's not parallel. AB, that would be this line, we didn't want to do with that line. CF, that's this line, but we didn't want to do with that one. Hopefully it's this last one. AB, line BF. Six. They tell us angle one is that, angle five is that, angle 14 is that. They want us to find X and Y and show all of our work. Well, if I write those in here, angle one is 6X plus 45. Angle five, which is right here, is 3 times Y minus 10. Which is right here, is 8x plus 15. The first thing I'm going to do, I don't even care about any of these angles over here, so I'm going to get rid of that. I'm just going to redraw this. Sorry, I'm doing the wrong thing. I'm going to redraw these two lines. And this one is our transversal. I'm going to write in the stuff we know, 6x. 45, that was angle 1. This angle 5, was 3 times y minus 10. 14 down here was 8x plus 15. I know that these two together add up to be 180, but one of them's got an x in it, one of them's got a y in it, so I really don't want to set up that equation. These two lines are parallel. These two are alternate exterior angles, and they have to be equal to each other. So 6x plus 45 has to equal 8x plus 15. Get all the x's on one side. Get 45 equals 2x plus 15. Subtract 15. 2x. 30 divided by 2, get x equals 15. So that's part of your answer. Now to get the other answer, we can go back up here and plug in 6 times 15 plus 45. So 6 times 15 is 90 plus 45 is 135. So angle 1 is 135. That means that angle 5, those two have to add up to be 180. Angle 5, we subtract 135 from 180. We get 45. So this is 3y, or 3 times y minus 10, to equal 45. Distribute, get 3y minus 30 equals 45. Add 30 to both sides.